Hello, welcome to Tiny Automations. I'm Ryan. Today we're going to go through and look how we can use automation with emails, specifically custom mail hooks within make.com. I'll go through each step that we're going to do today. So this is an integration on make.com. The first step would be to create a custom mail hook. A mail hook will receive emails to a specific email address, and when we receive those emails, it will kick off this integration. The next step will be to analyze the text within the body of these emails, split it apart, and if it's relevant to what we're interested in, it will send us through a direct message in Slack. So we're going to use a real world example today that analyzes the email sent out by the Helper Reporter Out mailing list. This mailing list sends out emails 3 times a day, I think it is. They're quite high volume and they have a lot of text in them as well. So what we want to do is analyze those emails coming in. So they come in via the webhook. They are split. The actual emails within the body of the emails are separated by a bunch of hyphens. We'll use regular expressions to split them up. And then if they match certain keywords such as automation or whatever I'm interested in, they'll send it on to Slack. Now, the Helper Reporter Out mailing list, if you don't know what it is, it puts journalists in contact with sources. And if they write about you, they'll give you a backlink usually, and this can help you build up your blogging domain authority and backlinks. So it's a pretty handy thing to know. So let's get on to creating the scenario. First of all, we want to create a custom mail hook, and that's within webhooks. So custom mail hook. And what this does is it creates a unique email address that we can use for signing up to Helper Reporter Out mailing list. So let's just say Helper Reporter Out mail hook. Okay, click save. And as you can see, that's generated a unique email address. So we copy that address to the clipboard, and we have to sign up to Helper Reporter Out with that email address. I'll do that in the background. So once you've signed up with that email address, we need to test that it's all working. So we've copied that email address to our clipboard. We click run once, so the mail hook's running there. And then what we do is we create an email. Test content that is sent to that mail hook. Just wait for the email to go out. That's gone. There we go. And then if we click on this mail hook, we can see the output. And we've got the text in there, which is the body of the email. Great. Now let me just show you the kind of email we receive from Helper Reporter Out mailing list. So it's split into chunks with these hyphenated separators. So what we want to do is we want to split that up and then filter on our keywords that we want to send and be notified about in Slack. So again, let's go back to our scenario. Let's run that mail hook again. Send through the email to the mail hook. That's been sent now. There we go, we've received it. So again, we can click in here and see the text that's come through. So these items separate with these hyphenated lines here. So once we get an email from the Helper Reporter Out mailing list, it will kick off this scenario. So we receive the mail there. Now let's add a text parser, and we can use regular expressions to split the text that comes in from the email and analyze that. So the pattern we're going to use is just a very basic one. You could do something a little bit more efficient here, but this will just look for the hyphenated separators. and split that into chunks. And then after we've split into chunks, we'll do the filtering. It's probably not the most efficient way, like I said, but yeah, it's nice and simple. So we want it to have a global match, so it'll match each time it hits this pattern rather than just once. I'm not bothered about it being case sensitive. We say no on the multi-line, we say no on the single line as well. And let's just continue. So it won't stop if there's no matches. Text, we want the text from the previous node. Added that in there. And that should be good. Now let's just test this. So we'll save it, we'll save anyway. It just gives us a warning about it not being able to output, but we're just testing. So let's run, same again, run anyway. And let's create a test email using, and let me just stop that again because I didn't grab the email address. Copy that address to the clipboard, run it, get that mail up, put in the email address, test. Okay, let's send that. There it goes. Okay, great. Let's see what we've matched. As you can see, it's gone through and it's matched all of these items separated by this. So the actual value we want to use is in this $2. It's in this variable here called $2. Okay, so what we want to do now is get messaged about the relevant emails we receive. I'm going to get messaged in a channel within Slack. So you add in your Slack credentials here. I just do it selected from a list because it makes it easier. And I've set up a Harrow channel. And the text we want is the text from the previous node that got matched. But we don't want every item, so we want to add a filter here. So we set up a filter. Let's set up a keyword. So let's look for something as an example, something unique. Okay, let's say we want to write about Ahrefs. So let's copy that keyword. Keyword filter. And we want to do it on the match that we got previously. And we want it to be contains insensitive. And we'll just add Ahrefs in there. Click OK. So that filter's set up. So the text should come through here, be analyzed and split, filtered on Ahrefs, sorry. Okay, let's run that. Send through this test email. I've got to listen out for the, there we go, it's been sent, come through. It's matched, the filter's worked, and it says that one item has been sent through as a message. Let's check in our Slack. There we go. Perfect. Okay, that's it. So what we did today, just to recap, is we created a custom mail hook that takes in a mailing list email. It analyzes that email with the text parser node, filters for our keyword, and then sends through to Slack. Any ideas for any automations or anything, just hit me up at Tiny Automations on Twitter, or just leave a comment down here. Cheers.